Holy, he's upside down. What would cause that?
Turbine adjustment.
Holy.
Professional drivers.
New Canadian driver.
New Canadian. What caused it? No, he's in the median upside down. That's where it looked like maybe he fell asleep and went off into the median. Maybe, I don't know. I didn't see no brake marks or skid marks or nothing. Today I'm in car heaven. I'm scouring the auto wrecker. I'm looking for some ECMs, so this is one of my last yards to do for the spring at least. And then I'm going to be looking for a windshield for a Jetta. That white one has a little crack in it on the driver's side, so I called Dan's the Glass Man and got a price for a new one. But I'm gonna see if I can find a used one and just get him to install it. I've been scouring trying to find another parts Volkswagen, but I'm not having much luck, so I think I might have to purchase one today. And I remember when these were like $5, but now they're basically only select ones are worth anything anymore. All right, here's all the Volkswagens. Holy, they got quite a collection here too. Well, even a bus. Some Golfs, a Beetle. Ooh, that looks nice, all smooth out. It had a spoiler on it. They must have sold that already. Usually it's taken off ahead of time and thrown in the car because they know that they'll sell it, or they just, someone already bought it. I used to pull a lot of Volkswagen computers out in the yards, but it was mostly the 91s and 92s. But that was back a few years ago. Well, I think there's a new body style one, right? There's a 99. It's got a little scratch there. That's why they circled that. I can live with that one. All I need is that white one to pass the safety, so I don't think someone would really care about that. I don't think this one would pass the safety. Neither about that one. Neither that one. I think that one's probably my best choice here. Other ones are probably already gone. So it turned out to be a beautiful day to pull ECMs. I don't know if you can notice this, but look off in the background here. Look at all those cars that are all piled up. And then notice that orange thing over there. Well, that's their crusher. They can control their own market when they want to get rid of some vehicles, so they can stockpile them until the price is right. But from what I can see is half of the auto wreckers here in Ontario versus the other half held on to their inventory this winter, and the other half let it go so they could make more room. Now these guys have lots of vehicles, but they also have lots of capacity to be able to stockpile, and they have the means to crush them down to make even more room so they can kind of set their own price. I think around the magic number to move vehicles is about 300 ton. As soon as it'll hit that, that's when you'll see all these auto wreckers shipping out, and it should probably hit that next year. But this year it just was not going to go up that high, so some of these auto wreckers chose to hang on. Now their cash flow suffers, but at the same point they can get some more money for vehicles as well, like by picking stuff off of each one. So I got a good load today, so I'm gonna go up front and load up. But yeah, there's lots of interesting vehicles here, and lots of interesting stuff inside vehicles. I can see that they got a brand new HINO. And it's a 2011 or 2012, because it's got the urea on the side, I saw. But what a beautiful new truck. and they had this gate open by a remote. That's pretty handy. See if this beast can make the turn. They're not responsible for any nails that get in the tire, but their guys are busy working, so didn't have time to help me out. So I ended up getting that glass, so I'll transport it carefully. Hopefully it doesn't get nicked or chipped or cracked on the way home. These guys have been hard at that Volkswagen all day. Alright, and I gotta load up here. Brother, he said that this one is completely different than their other one. The insides are all digital. Everything. The interior is completely different. They gotta get it lettered and whatnot. And then this guy, he's got a nice old loader there. But he, the owner came out and he talked to me and he said that he wants to do some business with me. And, yeah, he said that he rents out the front part here to another competitor. So, hopefully my next visit here will be a good one. This time will tell.